Do you see? Because again, when colonization came, like we say, when the colonizator came, they brought the Bible with them and took the gold. Basically, they handed us on one hand the Bible, on the other hand they took the gold. Do you see? So there are, the many Africans also are victim of this, right there in Africa. Where now we have Africans and African governments who have been now brainwashed and programmed, who also think that somehow they owe something to Europeans. Well, we don't owe them anything. They owe us everything. But again, because of colonization, we had what we had and didn't know the value of it. The others knew the value of it, and also they came and they basically took it from under us. You know, as Amos Wilson say, we have a starvation in the middle of plenty, because we've been led to believe that somehow we depended on the others to feed us, when actually we are the one feeding everybody. But this is the trick how it works. So colonization has done a greatest damage to Africa, culturally speaking, politically and religiously, and even so, because again, see how the devilish European mind works. And see, I'm talking first hand here. I'm from Africa. I live there and I've seen them under colonization, and I see what they do. They knew that the resources that they needed were in Africa. They will come to Africa, of course, and try to get it. But how do we get it when the people in there? Do you see? So either you're going to either fight the people or fight the war, or else trick the people, and they don't boss. In some places they fought wars, and we had wars of resistance all over Africa against colonization. And of course, in other people places, they tricked us just to possess what was in the soil. So by the time we woke up, Africans were under subjugation by the colonial powers, and the colonial powers had the gold. Do you see? And this is the trick that they did to us. And then in turn around now, try to re-educate us, because we already educated. Because don't ever think that because somebody didn't speak French or English, he wasn't educated. We were educated, we had languages we were speaking. And we had norms and methods of things that we were learning. So, but they re-educated us in their educational system to make us now believe that unless you had their education, you were not educated. Which is a false word anyway. You know, we were educated in our own education. And therefore, they created this educated, quote-unquote, class, which is called miseducated class. Because now we were eagles, and they turned it into chickens, basically, and made us believe that we were educated. And in reality, we were brainwashed or Europeanized in the mind. And then now we were there as proxy to them. Since now we have been culturalized by them, we start thinking like them and acting like them and acting in their benefit rather than in the benefit of Africa and African people. Do you see? Because we were identifying with them. Same thing was happening in slavery. We were identifying with the master, and we thought that the interests of the master were our interests. When in reality that was not true, we would have been better off if we could kill the master. So the same thing in Africa, we are better off without the colonial powers. But somehow they educated us into believing that their interests were the interests of the colonial powers. And also, you know, by creating now this class system and this privilege system, they were able now to rob us from the resources. Do you see? And now causes also to be dependent on them, when in reality they were dependent on us. We didn't go to Europe looking for anything. They came to Africa looking for something. You have to think of this. No, Africans did not go to Europe looking for anything. When we were there, we were ruling. Do you understand? We were in Spain for 400 years or 500 years, ruling and educating them. Now, after that, they came to Africa, ruling and educating us. You see how they turned these things around. So that, and they made us forget who we were in the first place. and now trying to get us to be them or like them. That's why we have in Africa the split personality, or the what you call the triple heritage of now Africans acting like Europeans. You know, it's just like chickens, you know, eagles acting like chickens, you know. And also we have now Africans who think they are Europeans. Yes. And Africans now who are agents of Europe and European interests in the continent now in positions of power. Do you see? And this is what has happened with us, you know.
When you speak on the more Spain, there is a big misunderstanding of Africans actually being intelligent enough to teach the Europeans. Could you go into that, the Moors?
But again, this is another trick of them. Africans being intelligent, we were the first man. What do you mean being intelligent? If there is any intelligence, it's got to start with us. We were the first builders of anything. We were the first navigators of everything. We were the first astronomers of anything. You understand? So what are they talking about intelligence? Africans were intelligent. It's proven. They're still trying to figure out how to build these pyramids. We built them. We're not figuring out. We did. You understand? Africans gave birth to every civilization in the world. So what are they talking about intelligence?
So the pyramids, as some claim, didn't come from Martians.
Oh, man, come on. Get serious. I mean, come on. What is it? The Martians all of a sudden stopped coming here? If there were Martians there. What, did they just decided, well, we're not going to go to Earth anymore? Mm. See, they made us believe only all of these things. Same thing with this theory of evolution. If there was evolution, what is it? Evolution stopped somewhere, some time ago? No, there are no change in the course of nature. Things don't just stop being. It didn't stop just raining. It's been raining from the beginning of time, and it's going to rain to the end of time. So what? Well, what do you say? You used to have rain, and now it doesn't rain anymore. The world stopped raining. You see, they don't believe this garbage. The same flows of nature that happened a million years ago, the same things happen today. There were never any Martians who just somehow stopped coming here. So they came and they built pyramids and they left. I mean, get serious. Well, what do we have buried in the pyramids? Martian mummies? I mean, let's talk for real here. You see, don't believe this garbage, because once a liar, you be a liar forever. Because you have to cover as you go. Of course, the Europeans have lied to the world. They have lied to the world, the whole world. They've been everywhere in the world and lied to everybody. Now, in order for the lie to stand, they have to cover one after another. But if you look at the pattern, you will see, well, there are inconsistencies, because now you will find out that after all, they were lying all along. They would just try to cover it was a bad patch. This is the same thing that when they have found the ruins in of the people in Zimbabwe, of the Sun City, and they couldn't figure that Africans did this. So they were saying there was a white race in Africa so many thousands of years before, because somehow there is this jealousy here that they could not attribute this thing to Africans, that Africans simply could not possibly have built these places. You know, so they theorizing that there must have been some kind of European presence here 10,000 years ago. Come on, get serious. You know, but see, this is the thing they want you to believe. Don't buy into anything that they tell you. As a matter of fact, everything that they know come from us. We can go back into the books and you're going to find out an African presence in early Europe. We know that the European Renaissance was fueled by the presence of the Moor in Spain. The University of Toledo had 500,000 manuscripts. Don't take my word for it. Read the books. It's in the books. Look at the black presence in early Europe by Ivan van Sertima, or Moors in Spain. It will tell you that. Those books will give you detailed information about what I'm talking about here. So therefore, you will know that the European Renaissance was fueled by African learning and knowledge and technology. You know, now they turn things around to make you believe that you didn't know anything. We told you that, when in reality we told you first, and then you pretended that you knew it all along, and then you turn around and try to teach it us again.